हेलो फ्रेंड्स, कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन, दैट इज अ सरफेस डिसइनफेक्शन। सो यू पीपल कैन थिंक दैट सरफेस डिसइनफेक्शन इज वेरी इजी प्रोसीजर, बट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू हियर, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट। दिस इज व्हाई यू विल कम टू नो इन दिस वीडियो। सो देर आर टू काइंड ऑफ सर्फेसेस अवेलेबल इन डेंटल क्लिनिक। द वन इज अ क्लिनिकल कॉन्टैक्ट एरिया, द एरिया विच वी यूज टू टच विद अ ग्लोव्ड हैंड, एंड द अनदर इज अ हाउसकीपिंग एरिया। सो दिस इज अ क्लिनिकल कॉन्टैक्ट एरिया वेयर वी यूज टू टच विद अवर ग्लोव्ड हैंड मोस्टली। And in the housekeeping area, your floor, wall or the sinks can be considered. So how to disinfect these surfaces? So CDC recommended use of EPA registered product, which should be a low level or intermediary level disinfectant. So CDC recommended to disinfect all the clinical contact areas in between two patients. This is because cross contamination can occur to operator's hand while handling these surfaces. And for housekeeping surfaces, we have to use low level disinfectant with detergent. And when blood spills occur, we have to use sodium hypochlorite solution. So let's see how we have to disinfect these surfaces. And again, this disinfectant should be hospital level, that they should claim effective against Salmonella, Staphylococcus aureus or Pseudomonas aeruginosa. And it should be labeled as effective against HIV, HBV or tuberculosis bacteria. So let's see what are the level of disinfection. There are three level of disinfection, that is a high level, intermediate level and low level. So high level disinfectant is capable of killing bacterial spores when used in sufficient concentration for a required contact time. Again, this contact time is very important while using any disinfectant. This is because a particular disinfectant have a particular contact time for killing that bacteria or viruses. Then intermediate level disinfectant destroy all vegetative bacteria including tuberculous bacteria, including tubercle bacilli, lipid viruses, some non-lipid viruses and fungi, but not bacterial spores. Then low level disinfection kills all vegetative bacteria except tubercle bacilli, lipid viruses, some non-lipid viruses and some fungi, but not bacterial spores. So that is the difference between these three level of disinfectant. So now how to do surface disinfection? So you have to consider disinfection of surfaces through two steps. Generally what we do, we spray chemicals and we wipe it out without keeping it for a particular contact time, and we do this procedure through the single step, which is not a sufficient for surface disinfection. This is because clinical contact area or the housekeeping area, it mostly get covered with a dust particle or the saliva or the debris or protein like material or the blood. So these contaminants prevent your disinfectant from reaching up to the bacteria or the viruses, and that's why you have to sanitize or you have to clean these surfaces before you disinfect it. So for cleaning, you can use those disinfectant which are labeled as cleaner and disinfectant both, or you can consider cleaning through the use of soap and water or detergent. So after cleaning, you are able to expose these bacteria to the disinfectant. So the second step is disinfection, in which you have to consider disinfectant as per CDC guideline. Again, here you can use hydrogen peroxide and silver nitrate combination in 10% concentration or 5% concentration as per the requirement. If you are going to clean a non-critical areas, you can use 5% concentration. For a semi-critical areas, you 10% concentration, and for a critical areas, you can 20% concentration. So while doing disinfection, you have to spray this disinfectant on the clinical contact area, and you have to keep it for a particular contact time recommended as per the manufacturer guideline for that product. So if you want to see which chemicals are sufficient for this purpose and what is the contact time of this chemical against coronavirus, you can visit a class N list of EPA registered products or EPA registered disinfectant against coronavirus, which is available on CDC website. So as per this list also, hydrogen peroxide can kill these viruses within a 10 minutes. Again, sodium hypochlorite is also a good disinfectant which we can use for this purpose. But while using sodium hypochlorite, you have to consider material compatibility of sodium hypochlorite. If you want to clean floors with sodium hypochlorite, it is a best solution which is a very cost effective. As per the CDC guideline, in the current scenario of coronavirus, you can use this chemical in your homes also. So let's see how much concentration is required. You have to add 5 tablespoons of bleach per gallon of water. That means in around 3 liters of water, or 4 teaspoons in 1 quart of water. That is around in 1 liter of water.